Can you safely upgrade your unsupported Mac to the new macOS version 13.0.1? Let's find out. Apple released the first update for macOS Ventura 13.0.1. And with the numbering, you can already see that is not a big update. No big features that were added. It's just a more bug fixing and security update. So the question is, with unsupported Macs like this MacBook Air here from 2013, should you already upgrade? Basically, you always should upgrade because you get the latest security fixes, but that might break your OpenCore installation here on the unsupported Macs and it might not be bootable anymore. If you have any other questions about macOS Ventura or Monterey on unsupported Macs, I recommend my ultimate tutorial about that with a big Q&A section, questions and answers, and helpful tips, and a detailed step-by-step tutorial how to install the unsupported macOS on your old Mac. And it doesn't have to be a MacBook Air like this one. It can be a MacBook Pro, an iMac, a Mac Mini, or a Mac Pro. Basically, 2012 and younger can run macOS Ventura. But be careful, the Mac Pro 2012 cannot yet run Ventura. That starts with Mac Pro 2013, the old garbage can. So I tried the new update here on my MacBook Air 2013 and on the Mac Mini 2014, and I already got some feedback from the community. Searched through the forums, there is no problem at all with 13.0.1. And it's really easy. If you have the latest OpenCore installed, and you should always do that, 0.5.1 is the latest OpenCore legacy patcher version. When I record that video, just update OpenCore or make sure it is the latest version and update it like any supported Mac. With macOS Ventura though, there is one speciality with the update function. As soon as you've applied the post-install root patch, the incremental update function is broken. So what does that mean? It means you always have to download the full Ventura installer, 11 to 12 gigabytes. Before the root patch, you can see that the update originally only had about 400 megabytes, but due to the kind of root patching they had to apply here to get the graphic drivers back into Ventura, this function is not working anymore and you need the whole download. But that doesn't make any difference for the update. Just download the whole installer, do the update, and it works as with a supported Mac. And after that, OpenCore Legacy Patcher will detect there was an update because every update breaks your root patch. So don't be scared if you do the update and the graphic starts feeling slow and looking weird, because the graphic acceleration is in most of the old Macs the problem where you need the post-install root patch for. After that, OpenCore will just pop up and say, okay, see, you did an update, the old root patching is broken, shall I apply it again for you? You just click yes, it starts the root patching, and one more reboot and everything should be up and running again and running smoothly and fine. What about OpenCore Legacy Patcher? Is there any update upcoming? Yes, it is. If you check the link also in the video description, if you check the change log that is at the GitHub repository, you see the changes the devs are right now working on. There is one runaway issue with the Mac Pro 6.1 that they have already been fixed, and they have implemented the AMD Polaris graphic stack. You can read all the details here in the changelog, but these are all the updates that will be in the next release. I think it would be 0.5.2 of the OpenCore Legacy Patcher. I will keep you updated as soon as this one will be released, if there are any problems or what are the final patch notes. And I'm already working on a video, just for a little bit preview right now, I'm working on a video to install Windows 10 or 11 on the unsupported Macs. How to do that if you only have one hard drive, like here, where you can just not add another one, like in a Mac Pro. How can you install Windows parallel to macOS? So happy updating. See you soon. Bye bye.